We're asked to solve the given equation. Notice how the given equation is a degree 2 equation, which means this is a quadratic equation. To solve a quadratic equation by factoring, we set one side equal to 0, factor, and then use the zero product property to find the solutions. However, for this equation, we'll be using two methods. In the first method, we'll clear the fractions from the equation before solving, and then for the second method, we'll leave the fractions in the equation. So looking at the fractions in the equation, notice how the least common denominator is 3, which means we can clear the fractions from the equation by multiplying both sides by 3. Let's begin by doing this. We'll multiply both the left side and right side by 3. So we'd have 3 times 1/3 y equals 3 times the quantity 1/3 y squared minus 2y. So on the left side, 3 times 1/3 is equal to 1. 1 times y is y, so we have y equals. On the right side, again, 3 times 1/3 is 1. 1 times y squared is y squared. And then we have minus 3 times 2y, which would be 6y. And therefore, the right side is y squared minus 6y. Notice how the degree 2 term, or the y squared term, is positive, and on the right side of the equation. So now let's set the left side of the equation equal to 0 by subtracting y on both sides. Simplifying, on the left, y minus y is equal to 0. So we have 0 equals y squared, and then negative 6y minus y, or negative 6y minus 1y, is equal to negative 7y, which we'll write as minus 7y. Now that we have the left side equal to 0, we'll factor the right side. The first step in factoring is to factor out the greatest common factor. The greatest common factor between y squared and negative 7y is y. If we don't recognize this, we can write y squared as y times y, and then minus 7y can be written as minus 7 times y. In this form, we can see the greatest common factor between these two terms is just one factor of y. So now we'll factor out y from the right side of the equation. If we factor out y from y squared, we're left with one factor of y, minus, if we factor out y from 7y, we're left with one factor of 7. So the factored form of y squared minus 7y is y times the quantity y minus 7. And now to solve, we use the zero product property, or the principle of zero products, which means if this product on the right is equal to 0, either the first factor of y must equal 0 or the second factor of y minus 7 must equal 0. And now we solve these two equations for y. Well, this equation here is already solved for y. So one solution is y equals 0, or to solve y minus 7 equals 0, we add 7 to both sides. Simplifying, we get y equals 7. So the given equation has two solutions, y equals 0 or y equals 7. Now let's solve this equation again and work with the fractions in the equation. So beginning with the given equation, let's set the left side of the equation equal to 0 by subtracting 1/3 y on both sides. Simplifying, on the left, 1/3 y minus 1/3 y is 0, so we have 0 equals 1/3 y squared, and then we have negative 2 y minus 1/3 y. Let's work this out on the side. Let's write negative 2 y as negative 2 over 1 y, and we have minus 1/3 y. Notice how the least common denominator is 3, so we'll multiply the numerator and denominator of negative 2 over 1 by 3. This gives us negative 6/3 y minus 1/3 y, which equals negative 7/3 y. So the right side of the equation is 1/3 y squared minus 7/3 y. And now we want to factor the right side of the equation. To help us do this, let's write 1/3 y squared as 1/3 times y times y. And let's write 7/3 y as 1/3 times 7. There's the 7/3, times one factor of y. So to factor the right side of the equation, let's go ahead and factor out a factor of 1/3 as well as a factor of y from both terms. So factoring out 1/3 y from the right side of the equation, if we factor out 1/3 y from 1/3 y squared, we're left with a factor of y minus, if we factor out 1/3 y from 7/3 y, notice how we're left with one factor of 7. Now that we've factored the right side of the equation, we once again use a zero product property to find the solutions. If the product on the right is equal to 0, either 1/3 y is equal to 0 or y minus 7 is equal to 0. Solving 1/3 y equals 0 for y, we would multiply both sides by 3. Gives us y equals 0, or solving y minus 7 equals 0 for y, we add 7 to both sides, simplifying, we get y equals 7. So notice how, regardless of the method we use to solve the given equation, we get the same solutions, y equals 0 or y equals 7. I hope you found this helpful.